You may think being totally blind is the greatest challenge I face, but actually, it's the fact that I'm often wide awake at 3 a.m. and struggling to stay awake in the middle of the day. This is called non-24, and it affects up to 70% of people who are totally blind, like me. It makes just getting through the day a real struggle. Learn more about non-24 by calling 55-856-24.
Money on Medicare Part D? Switch your prescriptions to Walgreens. With co-pays as low as $1, you could be looking at some. And now you can preview the cost of
or visiting learnmorenon24.com.
Sponsored by Vanda Pharmaceuticals.
Good morning. It's Sunday, January 10th, 2016. 57 degrees. Windy today with highs around 60.
Live from the Glass Enclosed Nerve Center, this is Washington's top news, 103.5 FM and WTOP.com. Here's Nick Iannelli.
It was a sad and shocking scene when investigators found 66 dogs in a house in Rockville. A few had to be put down, and now a little over a week later, some are waiting to find a new home.
Having 66 in a home, there's obviously going to be concerns about the health and safety.
Thankfully, Catherine Tanzano with Montgomery County Animal Services says three of the dogs had to be put down.
The animals were in pain.
But many of the others are up for adoption. Some of them
perfectly, normal, happy dogs.
The various shelters and rescue groups are helping with about half of the animals, which have some special needs, including medical or behavioral issues. It was a dog bite investigation that led officers to the home. That case has been closed, and the dog at the center of it wasn't one of those picked up. To see pictures of the dogs up for adoption, go to WTOP.com. Search Rockville 66. Mike Marlowe, WTOP News.
Gas prices have been falling sharply over the past couple of years now. In Northern Virginia, that means gas taxes are down too.
The special Northern Virginia sales tax for local road and transit projects isn't a flat rate. It's tied to the cost per gallon without the bottom floor the statewide tax has. And VRE CEO Doug Allen is setting a minimum that will draw millions more across the region as one of his top requests as the General Assembly gathers Wednesday in Richmond.
The fuel tax that we talked about, beginning the process of trying to identify additional funding.
More money would also mean more road construction aimed at easing your commute. While Commonwealth Transportation Board member Gary Garzinski.
still doing the output of money out of their house. Their trucks are straight white rounders. They carry a
is Kensington. This is where Station 705 is.